Good morning, students. Welcome back to ICT class. This is our video session 21, and from previous class onwards, we have started a new lesson, chapter 4, Python graphics. So in the previous class, we have discussed about the introduction part about Python graphics, the windows which we are going to perform this Python platform on, as Python shell, Python editor window to do the program and to for viewing the result, Turtle graphics window. And we have discussed about some graphical commands used in this Turtle graphic: forward, right, left, dot, etc. And also we have discussed about the first program, how to draw the geometric shape called square by using Turtle graphical commands. So hope you all have clear about how to draw a square. So in today's session, we are moving to other three programs. One is how to draw triangle, and next one is how to draw a pentagon and how to draw a hexagon. So three more programs are there in your textbook. So you can see it in page number 48. You can see that code lines. So we are going to perform triangle. So in the similar way, how to draw a triangle, we have already studied about this 4i in range of 4, then forward 100, then right 90. You have already here turtle import is there. Header file is there, turtle import star. So you have already seen that how to draw a square. So what are the changes we have to make in order to draw a triangle? How many sides are there for triangle? 3 sides. So this instruction must repeat how many times? 3 times. So instead of 4, give 3. Okay, so 3 times this instruction get repeated. And what about the angle? For square it is 90 degree. Here it is 90 degree. What about triangle? For drawing a triangle, always take the exterior measurement. Here it is 60 degree. For an equilateral triangle, it is 60 degree. So how to get this external measurement? Either you can do it by 180 minus 60. So here you will get 120 degree. So you must, here you should write 120 degree for drawing a triangle. Either you can do like this, or you just do the calculation 360 by sides 3. Okay, so you will get 120. So this is the basic program for drawing a square. What about pentagon? How many sides? 5 sides are there for pentagon. So instead of 3, give 5. Okay, for drawing a pentagon, give 5. What about the angle? Angle will be 72. Okay, for drawing a pentagon, angle will be 72. You can do it using the symbol calculation, 360 by 5. For hexagon, 360 by 6. So in the similar way, we can do all this geometric shape by using this command line. Just change the range and angle. Okay, how many times it should get repeated, this step, and also change the angle. So we are going to perform this 3 activity. So let's see it using Turtle graphics window. Okay,
so here is the program for doing triangle, how to draw a triangle using Python. So instead of giving 4 side, triangle has 3 side. So change here 3, and also here left 120. For square we have given right 120. So if you give right 120, what will happen? I'll show. I'm giving right 120 degree. Exterior angle measurement should be given inside this right column. Then I'm going to run this module. Then you can see here we got the mirror image of the triangle. So to draw a triangle like this, we have to specify here left LT. So you can see the change. So where the turtle stand, from that it takes the left degree. So we got the triangle. So we can either do right or left according to our image. We can make changes according to our result. Okay, so this is the program for drawing a triangle. Then how to draw a pentagon? What are the changes we need to make in this program? For pentagon there are 5 sides, so 5 times the step to be executed. And here instead of 120, give the measurement. exterior measurement, or you can do 360 by 5, then you will get 72 degree. Then I am going to run this program. Here either you can give full spelling of left or give the short form LT. No issue in that. I am going to run this module. Click on OK. Then you can see the corresponding pentagon. So this is a turtle. This arrow mark is known as turtle. So first forward 100. Then to left it will take 72 degree and row this again forward 100. So like that it will complete the pentagon. And if you are giving instead of left, if you are giving right RT, what changes will happen to our image? So that you can see pentagon in a reversed position. You can see the pentagon. So it is based on our turtle. Turtle will take its right and left. So in this manner we can do pentagon. And for hexagon, what all are the changes need to be changed? For textbook page number 48, program 4.2b, it is not given. The program code line is not given in your textbook. So from this picture you write the program in your textbook itself near to that hexagon. So the angle measurement you can see near to that box, you can see in the figure. So here how many sides for a hexagon has 6 sides, so range of 6. Here the angle is given in your textbook. How many exterior angle? 60. Outermost angle 60 or 360 by 6. You will get 60 degree. So write the program in your textbook page number 48. Don't forget to copy down this program. Then click on run module. Then you can see the corresponding hexagon. So in this manner you can draw different geometric shape. It is a sure question for your exam. So study triangle, rectangle, pentagon and hexagon. Okay.
So now you have seen how to draw different geometric shape like square, triangle, pentagon, etc. So we are moving to next activity, activity 4.3 in your textbook. How to create a pattern. You may be familiar with some pattern like a star, then other different patterns by using this lines. We are drawing some patterns. So in your textbook activity 4.3, you can see one pattern. So how to draw a pattern like that? By using this Python program. So we are going to use what? Nested loops. Okay, it is a new term for you. Nested loops. Before moving on to this nested loop statement, let's see some more commands. In the previous class, you have already learned forward command, right, then left, dot command, etc. So some more commands are there, some more graphical commands are there. One is clear. Clear, then put a open bracket and close bracket in order to clear the screen. Okay, it is used to clear the screen. So we'll get a new screen to show the output. So to clear the screen, clear function is used. Next function is pen size. Pen size of 5 means what? Pen size means we are drawing square, triangle, pentagon, etc. So this size, the thickness of this line is known as pen size. If it is pen, it will be more thickness like this. Thickness of line is known as pen size. So this all commands must be given before the for loop, which means after that from turtle in both star, then initialize this thing. One more is there, pen color. C-O-L-O-R, pen color of, in double quotes specify blue or red, yellow, etc. Means what? The line color. Okay. The line color can be indicated using this function pen color. So these are another 3 basic commands which should be used while doing this program. Okay. So now we are moving to the activity. How nested loop works. Okay. What do you mean by nested loop? We have executed this program by using looping statement. What was the looping statement? For loop, isn't it? We have used this for loop statement. So inside that for loop statement, we are going to use another for loop. So different, 2 different loops in one program. That is what known as nested loops. Loop to repeatedly perform 2 different statements or instructions. That is what known as nested loop. So this is the code for drawing that pattern. How does this code works? It consists of two looping statement, and it is known as nested looping statement. First one is I and next one is J. So what does this program indicate, or what is the meaning? This second looping statement, this much, this three looping statement, this statement is used to draw a square. It will draw a square. And the first looping statement means what? It will print the square how many times? 6 times in an angle. It will rotate that square in an angle of 60 degree. So that first it will draw a square. First square in 60 degree angle. 60 degree like this. 60 degree angle. After that again it will turn to 60 degree and it will draw next square. Second square. After it will turn 60 degree and will draw third square. Likewise, how many squares will draw? 6 times. So for drawing square, this code part is used. For printing it 6 times. Six times to print that square, first looping statement is used in an angle of 60 degrees. So after drawing each square, it will turn, that turtle will turn to 60 degree. So likewise, we can create a pattern. Okay, both statements are different. Different in their function. So let's see this activity, how it works using Python program. So now we can see this activity, activity 4.3 in your textbook. Okay.
Next program is for drawing a pattern, for drawing a square and printing that square 6 times. So first for loop I have initialized here. Page number 49, you can see the image, corresponding pattern and corresponding code of that pattern. So first for loop I in range of 6 and write 60 degree. And if you press enter key, you can see the cursor here. So this is the greatest advantage of Python, which indicates what? It has a systematic syntax for Python language. So inside this for loop, we are going to initialize next for loop. This is what this tab space indicate. So type next for loop with next variable j. J in range of, you can give any variable like a, b, any variable you can give instead of that ing. Range of, for drawing a square 4 times the instruction to be repeated, put a colon. If you press this, put this colon, if you press enter key, you can see that our cursor is now inside this for loop. If you forget to give this colon, what will happen? Our cursor is here. So the computer don't understand whether the statement is belong to here or this. So now if the cursor is in this place, the computer will take this instruction based on our first for loop. Okay. So always put the colon. Don't forget to put this colon. It is the inbuilt syntax of Python. And if you press enter key, the cursor automatically will appear here inside the second for loop and give the instruction for drawing square FD, forward 100. Then what? Right 90 degree. Okay. So this is the nested loop condition, which means first it will draw first square. After that it will turn, rotate 60 degree. Again, it will draw next square. Again, it will turn 60 degree. And again, it will draw next square, third square. Again, it will turn 60 degree. Likewise, how many times it will do this step? 6 times. So we'll get 6 squares. If here it is 5 times this process will get repeated. So this 3 code line is for drawing square only. 1 square. For drawing 1 square, this code line is used. That 1 square will get printed 6 times with a rotation of 60 degree. For that, 2 repeating statements are here. Each time, every time we have to draw 1 square, as well as it is to be printed and rotated in 60 degree 6 times. So 2 repeating statements are here. That's why we are using 2 looping statement. It is called as nested loop. Now let's see the answer. Run module, click on OK. Here you can see first square, second square, third square, fourth one, fifth one, sixth one. Okay. So likewise 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 squares are printed. 6 squares. 6 times. The square are printed, and then here you can see a rotation of 60 degree. Okay, in a rotation of 60 degree, you can see if you don't give this corresponding code line, then you can see the difference. If you click on run module option, then you can see like this. Okay, there will be no rotation. 6 times the same square is going. So for creating a pattern, we are giving RT60. Okay. So in this code line, we can add some more graphical commands like clear, pen size, pen color, so that you can see the corresponding changes. Clear means to clear the screen, and then pen size. Pen size indicates the thickness of the line. So I am giving pen size of 5. Then we can specify pen color also. It is not in your textbook. If you want, you can give like this. In double quotes, give blue, red, green, etc. Close the double quotes, close bracket. So this commands, this graphical commands always give above the for loop. Okay. After the header file initialization, give the corresponding code, then write the for loop condition. So now we can run this module. Click on OK so that you can see the corresponding change. What has happened? The line thickness will be 5 and the color will be blue. In the similar way, we can change the color into red. Then here we can change to 10. Then run this module. Click on OK so that you can see the thickness of line has increased, and also our code, our color has changed to red. So in this manner, you can give the corresponding lines also. Okay, so this is the method of creating a pattern by drawing square. Here you can see our turtle.
So that's the nested loop condition. So in today's class, we have discussed about two small activity owners, how to draw different geometric shapes like triangle, pentagon and hexagon, and also activity 4.3 in your textbook, how to draw a pattern. So the we have used nested loop condition, two loops in one program. One for loop is for drawing square, and other for loop is for rotating that square 60 degree and printing one square 6 times. So 6 squares will be there in the pattern. So printing a square 6 times with an angle, rotation of angle 60 degree, we have used nested loop condition. So for drawing pattern like this, in every program we can use two for loop, which means nested loop condition we can use. Okay, to repeat that program that much time, how many times we want to repeat that program, we can specify that particular timing range function, and we can use this nested loop condition. So hope you all clear about today's class. Write the notes and write the program and study, then only we can memorize the programming statements. Okay, so there is a homework for you. So we'll see in the next class. Thank you and have a nice day.